That's the idea behind a technique that I'm going to describe to you called ballooning. The idea is to have a special device driver installed in every guest operating system. So even if it is a fully virtualized setting, since device drivers can be installed on the fly with the cooperation of the guest operating system, the hypervisor can install the device driver, which is called a balloon, in the operating system. And this balloon device driver is the key for managing memory pressures that may be experienced by a virtual machine or a guest operating system in a virtualized setting. Let's say that the house needs more memory suddenly. And this may be a result of another guest operating system saying that it needs more memory. So what the hypervisor would do is it'll contact one of the guest operating systems that currently is not actively using all of its memory, let's say, and talk to this balloon driver that it is installed through a private channel that exists between the hypervisor and the balloon driver. So this is something that only the hypervisor knows about, because this is a special device driver that the hypervisor has installed. It knows how to get to this device driver and tell it to do something. And in this case, what the hypervisor is going to do is tell this balloon device driver to inflate. What that means is that this balloon device driver is going to make requests to the guest operating system saying, I need more memory, I need more memory, I need more memory. And the guest operating system will, of course, give this balloon driver the memory that it is requesting. And since the amount of physical memory that's available to the guest operating system is finite, if one process, in this case the balloon driver, is making requests from the guest saying, give me more memory, guest has to necessarily make room for that by paging out to the disk unwanted pages from the total memory footprint of all the processes that are currently running in this guest operating system. And once it is done, the swapping out of pages and perhaps even entire processes out onto the disk, that's the way it can make room for the request that is coming from this balloon driver. Now, once the balloon driver has gotten all this extra memory out of this guest operating system, it can return those physical memories, the real physical memory or the machine memory, back to the hypervisor. So we started with this house needing more machine memory, and the way the house got that more machine memory is by contacting its balloon driver installed in one of the guest operating systems that is not actively using all of its resources, asking the balloon to inflate. And inflating the balloon is essentially meaning that we are acquiring more memory from the guest operating system. So you can see visually that the footprint of the balloon goes up because of the inflation. That means it's got a bigger memory footprint, and all of this memory footprint is extra resources that it can simply return to the hypervisor. It's not going to use it. It just wants to get it so that it can return it to the hypervisor. So that's this path here. So the opposite of what I just described is the situation where the house needs less memory, or in other words, it has more memory to give away to a guest operating system. So maybe it is this guest that requested more memory in the first place, and in that case, it wants this guest to get the memory that it wanted. And the way it can do that is as follows. Once again, the hypervisor, through its private channel, will contact the balloon driver and tell the balloon driver to deflate the balloon. By deflate, what is being instructed to the balloon driver is to contract its memory footprint. So if it contracts its memory footprint by deflating, it is actually releasing memory into the guest operating system. So the available physical memory in the guest operating system is going to increase because of the fact that the balloon is deflating and giving out the memory that it is currently sitting on. So now the guest operating system has more memory to play with. That's the effect of the balloon deflating, is that the guest operating system has more memory, which means that it can page in from the disk the working set for processes that are executing on this guest operating system so that those processes can have more memory resources than they've been able to because of the balloon occupying a lot of the memory. So this technique of ballooning assumes cooperation with the guest operating system so that based on the need of the hour, the hypervisor can work with the guest operating system implicitly without the guest really knowing about it because it is all happening through this balloon driver that has been installed by the hypervisor in each of the guest operating system. And this technique of ballooning is applicable to both fully virtualized and para-virtualized environments to ease the overcommitment of memory by the hypervisor to the guests. I mean, it's sort of like airline reservation. You always notice that in airline reservation, the airlines tend to sell more seats than what they have with the hope that someone is not going to show up. That's the same sort of thing that is being done here, that there is a finite amount of physical resources available with the hypervisor, and it is doling it out to all the guest operating systems. And what it wants to do is it wants to be able to reacquire some of those resources to satisfy the needs of another guest operating system that is experiencing a memory pressure at any point of time.